मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, द टॉपिक ऑफ टूडेज लेक्चर इज फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट। फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट मीन्स प्लानिंग, ऑर्गेनाइजिंग, डायरेक्टिंग एंड कंट्रोलिंग द फाइनेंशियल एक्टिविटीज सच एज प्रोक्योरमेंट एंड यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ फंड्स ऑफ द एंटरप्राइज। इट मीन्स अप्लाइंग जनरल मैनेजमेंट प्रिंसिपल्स टू फाइनेंशियल रिसोर्सेज ऑफ द एंटरप्राइज। स्कोप ऑफ फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट। इन्वेस्टमेंट डिसीजंस इंक्लूड्स इन्वेस्टमेंट इन फिक्स्ड एसेट्स कॉल्ड एज कैपिटल बजटिंग। इन्वेस्टमेंट इन करंट एसेट्स आर ऑल्सो ए पार्ट ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट डिसीजंस कॉल्ड एज वर्किंग कैपिटल डिसीजंस। फाइनेंशियल डिसीजंस दे रिलेट टू द raising of finance from various resources which will depend upon the decision on type of sources, period of financing, cost of financing and the returns thereby. Dividend decisions, the finance manager has to take decision with regards to the net profit distribution. Net profit are generally divided into two: dividend for shareholders, dividend and the rate of it has to be decided. Retained profits, amount of retained profits has to be finalized with which will depend upon expansion and diversification plans of the enterprise. Objectives of financial management. The financial management is generally concerned with procurement, allocation and control of financial resources of a concern. The objectives can be to ensure regular and adequate supply of funds to the concern, to ensure adequate returns to the shareholders, which will depend upon the earning capacity, market price of the share, expectation of the shareholders. Next, to ensure optimum fund utilization. Once the funds are procured, they should be utilized in maximum possible way at least cost. To ensure safety on investment, that is, funds should be invested in safe ventures so that adequate rate of return can be achieved. To plan a sound capital structure, there should be sound and fair composition of capital so that a balance is maintained between debt and equity capital. Functions of financial management. Number one, estimation of capital requirements. A finance manager has to make estimation with regards to capital requirements of the company. This will depend upon expected costs and profits and future programs and policies of the concern. Determination of capital composition. Once the estimation have been made, the capital structure have to be decided. This involves short-term and long-term debenture equity analysis. This will depend upon the proportion of equity capital a company is possessing and additional funds which have to be raised from outside parties. Number 3, choice of sources of funds. For additional funds to be procured, a company has many choices like issue of shares and debentures, loans to be taken from bank and financial institutions, public deposits to be drawn like in form of bonds. Number 4, investment of funds. The financial manager has to decide to allocate funds into profitable ventures so that there is safety on investment and regular returns is possible. Number 5, disposal of surplus. The net profits decision have to be made by the finance manager. This can be done in two ways. Number one, dividend declaration. It includes identifying the rates of dividends and other benefits like bonus and retained profits. The volume has to be decided, which will depend upon expansional, innovational, diversification plans of the company. Number 6. Management of cash. Financial manager has to make decisions with regards to cash management. Cash is required for many purposes like payment of wages, salaries, payment of electricity, water bills, payment to creditors, meeting current liabilities, maintenance of enough stock, purchase of raw materials. Financial controls. The finance manager has not only to plan, procure and utilize the funds, but he also has to exercise control over finances. This can be done through many techniques like ratio analysis, financial forecasting, cost and profit control, etc. Importance of financial management. Financial planning is process of framing objectives, policies, procedures, programs and budgets regarding the financial activities of a concern. This ensures effective and adequate financial and investment policies. The importance can be outlined as adequate funds have to be ensured. Financial planning helps in ensuring a reasonable balance between outflow and inflow of funds so that stability is maintained. Financial planning ensures that the suppliers of funds are easily investing in companies which exercise financial planning. Financial planning helps in making growth and expansion programs, which helps in long-term survival of the company. Financial planning reduces uncertainties with regards to changing market trends, which can be faced easily through enough funds. Financial planning helps in reducing the uncertainties which can be hindrance to growth of the company. This helps in ensuring stability and profitability in concern. Now the tax. Tax are levied by governments on their citizens to generate income for undertaking projects to boost the economy of the country and to raise the standard of living of its citizens. The authority of the government to levy tax in India is derived from the Constitution of India, which allocates the power to levy taxes to the central and state governments. All taxes levied within India need to be backed by an accompanying law passed by the parliament or the state legislature. There are two main categories of taxes, which are further divided. These two main categories are direct taxes and indirect tax. There are also minor cess taxes that fall into different subcategories. Within the Income Act tax, there are different acts that govern these taxes. Direct tax is tax that are to be paid directly to the government by the individual or legal entity. Direct taxes are overlooked by the Central Board of Direct Taxes, CBDT. Direct taxes cannot be transferred to any other individual or legal entity. Income tax is the tax that is levied on the annual income or the profits, which is directly paid to the government. Everyone who earns any kind of income is liable to pay income tax. For individuals below 60 years of age, the tax exemption limit is Rs 2.5 lakh per annum. For individuals from 60 to 80, it is 3 lakhs. and above 80, the exemption limit is 5 lakhs. There are different tax slabs for different income amounts, which are upgraded or modified as per the annual plan. Apart from individual, legal entities are also liable to pay taxes. These include all artificial judicial persons, Hindu undivided family, body of individuals, association of persons, companies, local firms and local authorities. Capital gains tax is levied on the sale of a property or money received through an investment. It could be from either short-term or long-term capital gains from an investment. This includes all the exchanges made in kind that is weighed against its value. Direct tax also includes securities transaction tax. This tax is levied on stock market and securities trading. The tax is levied on the price of the share as well as securities traded on the ISE, Indian Stock Exchange. Pre-requested tax. These are taxes that are levied on the different benefits and perks that are provided by a company to its employees. The purpose of the benefits and perks, whether it is official or personal, is to be defined. Corporate tax paid by a company is defined as the corporate tax. It is based on the different slabs that the revenue falls under. The subcategories of corporate taxes are dividend distribution tax, fringe benefit tax, minimum alternative tax. Dividend distribution tax is levied on the dividends that companies pay to the investors. It applies to the net or gross income that an investor receives from the investment. Fringe benefit tax is a tax levied on the fringe benefits that an employee receives from the company. This includes expenses related to accommodation, transportation, leave, travel allowance, etc. Minimum alternate tax, companies pay the IT department through MAT, which is governed by Section 115JA of the IT Act. The companies that are exempt from MAT are those that are in the power and infrastructure sector. Indirect tax, taxes that are levied on services and products are called indirect tax. Indirect taxes are collected by the seller of the service or product. The tax is added to the price of the products and services. It increases the price of the product or service. There is only one indirect tax levied by the government currently. This is called GST or the goods and service tax. Earlier, there were VAT and other taxes. GST is a consumption tax that is levied on the supply of services and goods in India. Every step of the production processes of any goods or value-added tax services is subject to imposition of GST. It is supposed to be refunded to the parties that are involved in the production process and not the final consumer. GST resulted in the elimination of the other kind of taxes and charges such as VAT, octroi, custom duty, central value added tax, as well as custom and excise taxes. The products or services that are not taxed under GST are electricity, alcoholic drinks, and petroleum products. These are taxed as per the previous tax regime by the individual state governments. Taxes should be paid, and in addition to that, the fine as well as the interest is to be paid as the penalty. Other taxes are minor revenue generators and are small cess taxes. The various subcategories of other taxes are property tax. This is called real estate tax or municipal tax. It is levied by the municipal bodies based on each city. Professional tax. This involves employment. Tax is levied on those who practice a profession or earn a salary
income such as lawyer, chartered accountants, doctors, etc. Entertainment tax, registration fees, stamp duty, transfer tax, education cess, entry tax, road tax and toll tax. These are the different tax which come under other taxes. This tax, the road tax and toll tax, is used for the maintenance of roads and toll infrastructure. Benefits of taxes. The purpose of taxes is to provide the government with the funds for spending without inflation. Taxes are used by the government for a variety of purposes, some of which are funding of public infrastructure, development and welfare projects, defense expenditures, scientific research, public insurance, salaries of state and government employees, operation of the government, public transportation, unemployment benefits, pension schemes, law enforcement, public health, public education, public utilities such as water, energy and waste management system. Tax is levied on a wide range of income stemming from salary, profits from business, property rental, etc. There are also wealth tax, sales tax, property tax, payroll taxes, value added tax and service tax, etc. Advantages of paying tax. It is compulsory and beneficial for everyone who earns a taxable salary, which is one that exceeds the basic exemption limit, to file their income tax returns. This is the case even if the tax liability is zero. After deductions, here are some of the benefits of paying your taxes on time. Loan approval. When applying for a loan, especially home loan, vehicle loan, etc., major banks can request a copy of your income tax returns. This can be ITR from the last 2 to 3 years. Having ITR can even help to get a higher loan amount or to get your loan application reconsidered in case it was rejected at first. Visa applications. Many foreign consulates require you to furnish your income tax returns of the previous years during the visa interview, while for some the most recent one will be sufficient, others require up to 2 to 3 years worth of returns to be furnished. Self-employed individual. Freelancers, consultants, entrepreneurs and partners of firms are not eligible for the Form 16, so they require that loans, and that time it requires the proof of taxes paid by you. Government tenders. This depends on the individual government department with no specific strict rules, yet ITR receipts are sometimes requested to be furnished when applying for any government tenders. Carrying forward of losses. Short-term or long-term capital losses are usually carried forward to be adjusted against the capital gains made on the subsequent years. For example, the long-term capital loss of 1 year can be carried forward for up to 8 consecutive years that immediately succeeded the year in which the loss had occurred. Claiming tax refunds. Any refunds that are due from the IT department can only be claimed if income tax returns have been filed. High cover life insurance. Life cover or a term policy with sum assured that ranges from 50 lakhs to 1 crore can be availed only by furnishing income tax returns, which helps in the verification of annual income. Compensation for self-employed individuals. ITR receipts may have to be furnished in order to claim compensation in the event of a motor vehicle accident that results in a disability or accidental death. This is because in order to arrive at the appropriate compensation, income of the person is to be established first. Penalty for not paying taxes. The government can impose penalties of varying degrees on any individual or legal entity who evades taxes. The penalty is dependent on the category of the tax that has not been paid. This means that the amount that is owed as tax is to be paid as penalty.